Welcome to Beginning the Day with God on Wednesday, the 24th of May. We opened with Ole Jalo's Ubi Caritas. In the days between Ascension and Pentecost, for many centuries it was the habit of Christians to make the focus of their prayers the same as that of the first believers. Christ's instruction to his disciples on the day of his ascension is to wait for the gift my Father promised. The instruction to wait for the Holy Spirit is so important because without the Spirit's empowering presence, it is impossible to be a faithful witness to Christ. We need the gift of the Spirit to be the people God is calling us to be. O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Lord, open our eyes.
And we shall behold your glory.
Lord, open our ears.
And we shall hear your call.
Lord, open our hearts.
And we shall know your love.
Lord, open our hands.
And we shall show your generosity.
Lord, open our lives.
And we shall reveal your glory.
Father, you give us life. Jesus, you give us love. Spirit, you give us wisdom. Holy Three, you give us yourself.
Help us, O Holy One, to give our lives, to give our love, to give our minds, to give ourselves to you.
The Song of the Three. Blessed are you, the God of our ancestors.
Worthy to be praised and exalted forever.
Blessed is your holy and glorious name.
Worthy to be praised and exalted forever.
Blessed are you in your holy and glorious temple.
Worthy to be praised and exalted forever.
Blessed are you who look into the depth.
Worthy to be praised and exalted forever.
Blessed are you enthroned on the cherubim.
Worthy to be praised and exalted forever.
Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom.
Worthy to be praised and exalted forever.
Blessed are you in the heights of heaven.
Worthy to be praised and exalted forever.
We come now to this morning's reading. The first letter of John, chapter 4, verses 11 and 12. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us. Thanks be to God.
Our theme today from Thy Kingdom Come, the God who understands. The disciples were not a naturally cohesive group of people. Left to themselves, they were unlikely to have chosen to set up business together or even share a holiday. Matthew was a tax collector, working for the occupying Roman authorities. Simon the Zealot belonged to a group that opposed paying taxes to Caesar, some of whose members had been involved in a revolt. James and John, partners in a family fishing business on Lake Galilee, were known as Sons of Thunder, probably because of their fiery tempers and desire for power. The same John, who refers to himself as the disciple whom Jesus loved in the gospel that bears his name, becomes the apostle of love in his letter. His life has been utterly transformed, his character turned inside out by his relationship with the Lord Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit. We see divisions all around us: gender, race, language, education, upbringing, nationality. Things that in themselves could contribute to the diversity of God's creation become grounds for misunderstanding, strife, enmity, and even violence. Our Heavenly Father, like a master artist, has a palette of rich and varied colours which are designed to paint a beautiful picture of his creation, but which in our sinfulness and selfishness, pride and fear, we fashion into an unholy mess. In this mess, so often, the poor pay the greatest price of our inability to be God's reliable gardeners in his world. John calls us, in today's verse, to be defined by the love of God, not by anything else. St. Paul puts it very plainly in the letter to the Galatians. There is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free, nor is there male and female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. The five people that we have been praying for over the last few days, let us pray that they may find their identity in who they are in Christ. Living the kingdom must mean building churches and communities where love one another doesn't mean merely liking people who are like us. We are called to something much more radical, much more attractive. We are designed to be a community of servants, serving and being served by each other across all man-made barriers that so often divide and discriminate. Amen.
Come, my Lord, my light, my way. Come, my lantern, night and day. Come, my healer, make me whole. Come, my Saviour, protect my soul. Come, my King, enter my heart. Come, Prince of Peace, and never depart.
Amen.
Looking for the coming of his kingdom, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thanks be to thee, O God, that we have risen today. We have risen to life. We have risen to love.
Thanks be to thee, O God. You have opened our eyes. You have given us breath. You have made us move.
Thanks be to thee, O God, for you walk with us, for we dwell in you, and you dwell in us.
Thanks be to thee, O God, for this day and for our rising. Amen.
As we wait in silence,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we listen to your word,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we worship you in majesty,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we long for your refreshing,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we long for your renewing,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we long for your equipping,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
As we long for your empowering,
make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
Amen.